Hey, what's up guys, this is DaddyCool, and you are watching my Satisfactory playthrough with the subtitle Megafactory Online. The reason for this subtitle is that by the end of this playthrough I want to create a huge factory complex for the final products. I have checked before ahead what such a factory complex looks like and what size and time investment it requires. I tell you it now, it's way too much. Still, currently I feel the energy inside me, and I also think I will spend the necessary time to reach this goal of mine. Let's see how this plan works out. Enjoy the series, and don't forget, just have fun. So, I'm gonna start a new game here, and there are four possible places, locations on the planet where you can start, and from all of these four, the Dune Desert is the hardest, I suppose, because it's recommended for advanced pioneers only, and my plan is to create my final megafactory also in this area, so this is what I'm planning to do. The session name will be DaddyCool, and let's start it.
Separation from main transport complete. Group A delivered to Calistian region. All pioneers functional, initiating dispersion. Attention pioneer, I am Ada, your personal instance of the artificial directory and assistant. Welcome to the Fixit Incorporated Save the Day program. A Fixit pioneer has three core assignments. Construct. All pioneers must follow Fixit guidelines and instructions when constructing any building. Automate. Every pioneer is responsible for setting up and managing efficient pipelines, outposts, and power infrastructure. Explore and exploit. Fixit selected planets are rich with resources suitable for direct use or further investigation. Stay within your designated. And that is why the world is counting on pioneers like you. Fix it. Short-term solutions to long-term problems. Initiating planetfall. Atmospheric entry in 3, 2, 1. Beginning arrow assist. Drag within acceptable parameters. Down. Planetfall complete. Drop pod integrity nominal. Omni situational exploration suit nominal. Pioneer. Acceptable.
Landed in one piece. That's for sure.
Congratulations. You are the third in your region to survive planetfall. Welcome to Massage 2, ABB, in the binary system of Akicha. Loading objective-based introduction. Begin onboarding. First contact safety tool supplied due to presence of alien megafauna. Adhere to Fix-It procedure and equip the Fix-It Inc. Xeno Zapper before leaving the drop zone. Next objective, dismantle the drop pod. Fix-It Incorporated is cost-effective and efficient. We do not waste. The drop pod will be recycled to construct the first stage of the habitat and utility base, often referred to as the hub.
Okay, mission done.
Next objective, use the resource scanner to find and collect additional iron to be able to build the hub. If you cannot find iron, be assured scans of the planet have revealed sufficient iron sources.
So, we have arrived to this planet, and just as I have chosen, it's the Dune Desert, and as you can see, it's pretty empty. There is not real much to see here, no fauna and such. I'm gonna go here and check what we can see. There are some resources on that way, some resources in there. Okay, and I would like to head into that direction in distance because there are some fauna at that location, and that's pretty interesting, I think, for me.
Next objective, use the build gun to construct the hub. Iron is a base component necessary for all near future progress, so ensure you build the hub close to iron sources. Fix it does not pay by the kilometer.
Let's just attack these animals. Where is the other one? Ah, it was next to me. One of them is dead. Come on. Okay, that one is also dead.
Samples of new alien species acquired. Notable features are blunt teeth, suggesting it is herbivorous, and a thickly plated skull and spine, suggesting it is proficient at inflicting and receiving blunt force trauma. Preserve the remains for later study.
Okay, first counters done, and there is not much thing I can do in here. So the fauna was this way. Yeah, and I'm gonna collect the things I meet during the road there. Oh, we have some coal here. That's good. I mean, I will not be able to use it just yet, but later, a little bit later, that's gonna be useful. Okay, let's go further. Couple of resources here and there on the way. And a new enemy. Come on. There we go.
Samples of unknown alien species acquired. Their weaponized plasma is most likely stored as a stable chemical substance in an organ close to their mouth, and only turns volatile when exposed to one of the chemical elements in the air. Preserve the remains for later study. Potential edible collected. Eating it and surviving does not count as a valid field test and does not generate enough data for Fixit to make an informed decision. Store this potential resource for later use.
We have an enemy here. Somewhere next to me. Yeah, there you go. Come on, let's fight once more. Okay, this is also killed. So the reason why I came here and would like to start my initial base in the close vicinity is because of the water and the leaves and branches that are lying on the ground, like here. The very basic fuel is these leaves and wood that is lying here on the ground. As you can see, I can gather it pretty fast. So these are the basic resources, and let's check some iron. Well, a little bit further away, but it's on this direction. So probably it's a good idea to create the first base. Oh, another bunch of coal. So it's a good idea to create the first base near the iron source. and later, a little bit later, we will be able to relocate the hub. Wow, a lot of coal in this one. There you go. And I suppose the iron is there. Yeah, that's the iron. Very nice, I'm gonna mine it. And after that, I will decide... Oh, wanted to attack me. Come on, fight me. Okay, killed. So let's hop here and maybe hop here. There is one more resource in that direction, that's good. So we have iron here, copper in there, I have seen limestone in there. So this is gonna be a good location for the first building, the hub. Now, let's put it somewhere here in the middle. Yeah.
Hub foundation built. The hub terminal and crafting bench are only the humble beginnings of a successful fix-it pioneer, but essential for the next steps of onboarding. Once finished, the hub will function as your base of operations. Next objective, complete hub upgrade 1.
Let's check what are the requirements for that. I have to create 10 iron rods, and I will unlock the equipment workshop, the portable miner, and unlock an inventory slot, I suppose, or something like that. So let's create the iron ingots just really fast, and as you can see on the left hand side, it shows how many pieces of iron rods I will be able to create once I have smelted these iron ores into iron ingots. And I think I will create all of the iron ingots that I can, because in the beginning I have to do everything by hand. There is no real automation just yet, but that doesn't last long. Soon I will be able to unlock the necessary buildings to do so. So there are 10 pieces left from the ore. It doesn't take too much time. There you go. And we need 8 pieces of rods, but I will just create maybe 20, because I will need it for sure for other things as well. Let's load them. And hub is upgraded.
Hub upgrade 1, storage and frame completed. Equipment like the portable miner can now be made in the workshop. Congratulations on completing your first milestone, the first of many providing access to new recipes and technologies for the fix-it mission. Next objective, complete hub upgrade 2.
Okay, let's create the equipment workshop. Okay, I'm missing a few things for that, like iron plates. I'm gonna create a couple of those as well, because just like with the iron rods, I will need them for sure. So gonna create the equipment workshop, let's put it here. And what can I do? I can create portable miners. Okay, let's create at least one. Okay, and let's check what are the requirements for hub 2. I'm gonna unlock the smelter with that, the power line, copper ingot, copper wire, cable, and we can scan for copper. Okay, that's pretty good, and we need a couple of things for that. Let's put the iron plates in. And I think I have the miner, and I can put it here. And what I want to do with this, I would like to place it here, because this way I do not have to mine the ore by myself. This will automatically do it without any power source and such. The animation is really very cool. Okay, and it's working. In the meantime, I have seen, yeah, this in here.
Unknown chemical element collected. This non-metallic and multivalent element seems to be present only in a solid state and exhibits a most pungent smell. It is fortunate fixed helmets are of such high quality. Store this potential resource for later use.
Okay, let's check if I can create one more. Yeah, I can create one more portable miner. That's good. Let's visit that copper ore. It's gonna be a fight once again, I suppose. Yeah, there you go. I do not have the tool in hand. That was fast this time. And I'm gonna mine this copper here. Okay, and let's place the portable miner in here. Also deployed. Wonderful. And let's collect the iron from the miner in there. Because in the meantime, I think it has worked nicely. Come on. Yeah, 70 pieces of iron ore. So, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna create one more portable miner. Because I would like to put one of that on the limestone, which we have met just a little bit later after arrival. It's very close, so it's a good idea to put a miner there as well. And yeah, after that I will unlock the hub upgrade too. So I have a couple of ignots created. That's great. Let's create a couple of rods. And I think I will need a couple of plates as well. I will need a few more rods because 20 pieces are required for the hub. And if I remember well, I need 8 pieces of rods for the portable miner. That's great. Okay, create the miner and put it into, oops, I wanted to put it into the other hand. Come on, there you go. Now it's fine, and let's feed this here. New level unlocked.
Hub upgrade 2, power and shell, completed. The smelter can turn raw ore such as copper and iron into ingots, and the biomass burner generates power when fueled. Fun fact, most of the native flora and fauna is compatible with Fixit technology. Fueling the biomass burner with inappropriate materials will result in deductions or even cancellation of your yearly bonus. Next objective, complete hub upgrade 3.
Okay, we will concentrate on the next objective, but in the meantime, I think I have unlocked, yeah, the smelter, and for the smelter, we saw that we will require copper wire to be able to construct that, and I can do it in the workbench once again, so that's what I'm gonna do. Create a couple of copper ignots for the wires. I will craft a couple of pieces again because the copper wire will be needed very shortly. And maybe also I'm gonna create a couple of cables, I suppose. That's also seems to be a good idea. So create it up to 40, that's okay, and that's gonna be turned into 80 pieces of wires, and I think I'm gonna create maybe 10 pieces of cables just in case. It doesn't take too much time. Yeah, and create 10 pieces of cables. There you go. And let's create a couple of iron ingots. And after that I'm gonna check my inventory, because I think I have the sulfur in the middle of the line and a piece of remains in the end of the line in my inventory, and I would like to create, I mean, free up some space in case it's gonna be filled with something else. Okay, a couple of sheets, I mean iron plates, and the remaining piece is gonna be rods. There you go. So let's clear this out. Yeah, and let's check what is the hub upgrade 3. I'm gonna unlock the constructor, the power pole, concrete, screws, reinforced iron plate, and we can scan for the limestone. But just as I said, I already know where that is, and I have actually everything on hand for that. So let's just create it.
Hub upgrade 3, interior furnishing completed. The constructor can produce simple parts, and power poles allow for the expansion of the power grid. When you make the inevitable mistake, fix its dismantling feature is designed to salvage all resources used during construction, in line with our zero waste policy. We understand that Fix-It pioneers are only human, and thus prone to error. Next objective, complete hub upgrade 4.
Okay, and just for that objective, let's check what are the necessities. We're gonna unlock the conveyor pole, the conveyor belt, and all three inventory slots, that's good. And now I have to be able to create concrete. So just before I go there, let's place the first machine somewhere here. I'm gonna put a smelter in here, and just because I have feeded the wood into the biomass generator, I can add electricity for this machine and put the iron ore here, so that it's not my job anymore to create the ingots. Collect the iron. And actually this biomass generator has only one slot, I mean one cable slot, so I cannot just yet create another one. And the reason for that is because to create a pole you need the concrete. But wait a minute. I have some sandstone in hand because I have mined that. Let's create the sandstone as well. Maybe I do not have to leave this base just yet. But anyway, the sandstone mining would be a good idea to do. Let's put one pole here. I'm gonna put three poles here. That's the idea for the beginning. And let's remove this. Connect this to here. And I'm gonna put one pole in here. There you go, it's working again. In the meantime, I think I have some iron ore again. Grab all. Okay, and just because I can produce things now, I'm gonna put another smelter here. Let's give it some power. It's for the extra efficiency. A couple of iron ores. And I think I can create a copper smelter as well. Can I? No, I need two pieces of iron rods for that, but after that, yeah. That also seems to be a good idea, to be an efficient pioneer. Okay, and a couple of rods. There you go. And let's put the smelter here. Like this. Okay, you're gonna create copper. And I need some electricity into here. And there you go. Grab all the resource from here. So let's visit that sandstone. I'm gonna put the miner in there to be able to create more things. And in the meantime, of course, gathering some foliage here, because otherwise I'm gonna have some power issues if I cannot feed my my burner. There you go. I'm gonna let it work a bit, and in the meantime let's gather some things. And as you can see, the game is pretty nicely designed. I mean, there is no unnecessary animation speed for collecting the foliage, and I really like this. It's pretty fast. You are gathering the necessary things very fast. And later in the game this will change, of course, because I will use different resource for energy generation, but at the moment this seems to be a nice idea to gather everything you can, and the program lets you do it very fast. Okay, let's collect the things it has mined and back to the iron resource. Okay. And I think the machines has already some kind of problem, because they are lightning not green but yellow or orange. Grab all the iron pieces. Yeah, feed them with raw material. Feed this one as well. Raw material. Wonderful. Let's give this machine a little bit of wood. I'm gonna collect the copper as well. Grab all. Fill this one up. Take the finished product. And I think it's high time to create something new. I can create a constructor. It requires 8 cables, so let's just first create the wires for that. And I'm gonna create a little bit more wires, because for the hub upgrade I also need 20 pieces of cables. So 20 plus 8 is 28, and I like to have some cables in hand just in case. So that's what I'm gonna do here. Create cables. Okay, and I'm gonna create a couple of wires also for later use. That's gonna be needed for sure. I'm gonna use up all the ingots. Okay, what else? I can create 6 concretes, that's good, and iron plates. I'm gonna create a couple of pieces of that as well, but not all of them, because I wanna place the constructor, and it's gonna be here somewhere. Oh, I didn't create the reinforced plates. That's the problem. Yeah, we're gonna solve this. So the reinforced iron plates require iron plates, which I have, and a couple of rods for screws, and for two iron reinforced iron plates I need 24 pieces of screws. There you go, that's gonna be enough. Create a couple of rods as usual, just in case we need that. And I'm gonna create the constructor, and I would like to put that in line. Oh, and still didn't make the reinforced iron plates, just prepare that. Yeah, that's something I tend to miss. Prepare everything and not creating the product I was looking for. Okay, so now I can create it. Let's put it there. And what I'm gonna do, I wanna create here iron plates as well. That's the plan. Give some power from there. Great. And in the meantime, because this is full, but this is not really working on 100% efficiency, take it like this. I do not have any more iron ore in hand, but production is just not 100% efficiency at the moment, so it's not a big problem. Grab all, fill it here, take the copper. Okay, and yeah, now I can upgrade hub to 4 if I create the necessary things. Let's check them. How many plates? 50 plates. Okay, let's create the 50 plates. It doesn't take too much time, so it's not a big problem if I do it by hand, but a little bit later I will just pick up from the constructor for sure. So we have the necessary pieces very soon, and as usual a couple of pieces more, because it's a little bit easier that way. Let's give it to there and upgrade the hub.
Hub upgrade 4, landing platform and utilities completed. Conveyor belts connect the output of one building to the input of another and transport resources. Due to past incidents, I have been asked to issue a clarification. Portable miners, obviously, do not have a connection for conveyor belts. There is nothing to suggest, visually or functionally, that they can be connected to portable miners. If this is something you struggle with, do not worry. Fixit has alternative uses for all their pioneers. Next objective, complete hub upgrade 5.
Okay, let's check what are the necessities here. We're gonna unlock the miner, which is very good, and the storage container, which is also very good. And these are the requirements, so I'm gonna mark them in the menu. Let's check the burner. Okay, we are very good with resources, and there is one more thing I would like to do before visiting the limestone quarry once again. I can create the conveyor, and let's contact these things together. And I'm gonna take the resource from there. Let's feed this one. And let's take the iron plates. Okay, we are halfway automated at the moment. Okay, let's create these iron plates that I can make, and I wanna create a couple of more, maybe 4 pieces more. That sounds fair. 40, 48, that's good, and 4 pieces of iron plates just in case, as usual. Okay, and the next thing I would like to do is collect these things, put it here, take the ingots, and I wanna place a constructor here, further away. That's good. Connect these things together, set it into wire production, and connect online. That's good. Let's collect the iron as well. I'm gonna take it. What's this? We have something grown here. Strange. And set production. I'm gonna empty it. Set production into iron rods. That sounds good for me. Fill this one with raw resources. And that's also okay. So what I wanna do, I cannot create the concrete because I do not have sandstone in hand. And I suppose that's the next thing I would like to do. And I will have to do the cables sooner or later, so that is being produced as well. And I would like to... No, I'm missing the wires, but it's already being produced. So from there, let's take the electricity to the miner, limestone miner. And I'm not gonna put anything on this power line just yet, but I wanna prepare the things like this and collect limestone from here. And while it's working, I'm gonna collect some foliage here. Couple of branches and leaves. Yeah, mainly branches if I can, because it's it lasts longer. And once I have a couple of resources in hand... Oh, what's that blue thing? And what's this?
Potential edible collected. If consumed before authorized is compatible with the human digestive system by Fixit, the consumer is responsible for any and all consequences. Store this potential resource for later use.
Okay, that's what we are gonna do. And let's grab this blue thing. Blue power slug.
This semi-slug species seems to persist entirely through absorbing and storing energy from its surroundings. Studying this could provide new methods for improving Fixit production line efficiency. Store this potential resource for later use.
Okay, we will do so. So I have gathered a few resources. And let's collect the concrete material from there. And while I go back to the hub, I'm gonna collect a couple of more resources here. That's good. I'm gonna feed iron production once again, because that's the major thing that helps me extend and expand. Feed this one first. Yeah, it just got empty. And feed this one as well. Okay, so basically I should have everything on hand to be able to upgrade the hub. Yeah, iron rods. I need a couple of pieces only. And some concrete. So it seems I will have to gather the copper wire, yeah, because it's very low, the quantity on me, and I wanna create a couple of more cables. Now it's fine, I can feed everything here, and let's upgrade.
Hub upgrade 5, power expansion, completed. The miner, unlike portable miners, can be connected to conveyor belts and requires power to function. Caution, as you expand, the energy demand of your production may exceed the capacity of your power grid. The onboarding program was established because fix-it pioneers often experience memory issues after planetfall. If you are experiencing nosebleeds, nausea, existentialism, or an itchy scalp, there is no need for concern. This should pass within 5 to 7 workdays. Next objective, complete hub upgrade 6.
Now as you can see, there's another biomass burner here, which is pretty good because this means I can create a new constructor if I will have a couple of cables ready. And that way we can have iron rod and iron plate production going the same time if I can feed it properly with iron. And yeah, that's something we are missing here. Let's grab iron ore, put it here, and I wanna place the constructor a little bit further away this time. Maybe that's not gonna happen just that easy. Yeah, like that. So they are connected. You're gonna produce iron plates. And let's put all into here. Connect it to power grid like that, and we are working there. So regarding the inventory, I wanna put these things into the storage. Let's check what are the requirements for hub level 6. Space elevator, which is unlocked now. Biomass, or not now, will be unlocked. Biomass is the same. It will be unlocked, and it's very good because this is a more efficient way to create energy, and there are biomass is more efficient than the leaves and the wood, so that's a very good upgrade for us. Biomass burner, and it's separated from the hub, so I can place more biomass burners at a time. And these are the requirements. I will have to gather a couple of things, and we have unlocked the miner, which is pretty good. And I will start it with the oh, and the storage, yeah. So I will start to create the limestone miner, because limestone is still an issue. I can create the iron plates and the rods by myself, because I just collect the iron ingots that I have, and the copper wire is the same, but limestone is a little bit further away, so it's a good idea to start with that one. The automation, let's grab all the resources, pick up the miner. Let's place a miner in here. Okay, let's give it some power so it works. I'm gonna head that way. Okay, through the tree, why not? And I'm gonna place a constructor here as well. So belt is leading inside. Let's connect it into the system, and this is a concrete producer. We have a new resource here, it seems.
Unknown metal collected. This metallic element is showing properties similar to those in group 11 on the periodic table, such as high conductivity and malleability. Store this potential resource for later use.
I am gathering some more of these things because the burners are burning too fast. Or I am expanding too fast, one of the two. Oh, that's a couple of branches here, very good. There we go, 100, almost 200 pieces of wood, that's very nice. And I suppose that's gonna be enough for now. A few more pieces from here. Okay, and we are producing already in here. Let's get closer to the main base. That's okay. And I am missing some resources. That's the maximum I can go. I will collect the missing ingredients very soon. So, plates. These are the rods, these are the plates. And I am not sure about the exact location of the storage. Let's just put the storage in here. What's the feeding side? Like this. Yeah. Okay, that's within reach now. And here, let's grab the resource. Pick up that. I'm gonna create the iron miner in here. Connect this one here. And let's give it some power. Not that node. I think I will have to use the other one. Yeah. There you go. It's pretty nice. Let's feed this one. This one is also feeded. So now we have a production line, more or less. And can I make the next miner? No, I'm missing the concrete. So let's create a couple of concretes. And in the meantime, I'm checking also the resources I have in hand, because upgrading the hub is the next objective if I am satisfied with the current production line. Let's feed this with wood, this one with leaves. Okay, and create the miner. No, first of all I have to grab this one. Now I can place the miner in that direction. Connect them, that's good. Give it some power. There you go. This one is producing. This one is producing. And what's the problem now? Go. Too many buildings. Okay. Then let's detach this from the system. This means that I will have to upgrade the hub and place an additional burner. That's the way to go, I suppose. So let's gather the concrete from the storehouse, I mean the storage place. I'm gonna gather all the other resources and hopefully that's gonna be enough to upgrade. Collect this, collect the wires, now it's okay, and I think I have to feed this one, right. Okay, let's give the resources and I will see what we are missing, the iron plates, not a big problem. I can create that by hand, it's not that much. 41 pieces, and I'm producing two at a time, so it's really fast. A couple of more as usual. There you go. Feed it here and upgrade the hub.
Hub upgrade 6, landing platform hydraulics completed, freighter landing initialized. Congratulations, you have completed onboarding and achieved the absolute minimum skill level required of a Fix-It Pioneer. Fix-It looks forward to your future achievements, because a future with Fix-It is a future with you. Tier 1 and 2 milestones are now available in the hub, and biomass burners can now be built individually. Your first official objective is to initiate project assembly by building the space elevator. This objective will take a significant amount of resources, so Fix-It recommends getting to work.
Well, we have something here that has just arrived. So, what's next? Let's grab some iron or from here. I have to feed this line from here by hand, and I have unlocked the biomass burner. I need sheets, iron plates, like that. Let's put this into here and maybe one more next to it. Here is some resource. Let's gather it. Okay, and I think I have unlocked, yeah, the biomass from leaves. Let's just do that really fast. So the biomass is more efficient than the pure leaves. It's really worth to produce them, and the same applies to the wood. The biomass is more efficient than just putting the wood into the biomass burner. So I'm gonna create these for sure. And oh, we have a couple of things that we can choose from. And I'm gonna take this logistics tier 2. Oh, they are probably harder to acquire. So, logistics, that's the next thing. The splitter and the merger are very important things to have. Let's feed this with biomass, this one with biomass as well. And put them. No, not like that. Let's create a bowl here, connect these things to the bowl, and that one is full. How should I do this? There we go, put them online, and let's replace that, Now it's fine. Energy is not a problem anymore. And I have seen a yellow thing. Okay, we have excess iron ore here. Put it there, that's okay. And probably I will do space elevator. Ooh, too many resources. Yeah, a constructor to here. No, like this. Yeah, let's bind these together. And what about that pole? It's almost full. There we go. And you are gonna producing cables. So now I have a pretty nice line. Oh yeah, and the miner. Do I have to put it there? Whatever. I will redesign these things a little bit later for sure, so that it is lining the way I like things. So what's next? Let's check things here. Yeah, create a little bit more biomass from the leaves. There you go, and the wood, because electricity is priority number one. If everything runs smoothly, I will have plenty of resources on hand. If not, well, that's a little bit of problem. Okay, that's done. I think I am working properly now. Let's collect the iron rods. Iron plates in hand. That's the low quantity. How many wires do I have? Almost 300. That's good. I'm gonna create the iron plates by hand, I suppose. But before that, let's check this one. Take the iron ore, yeah, and feed it here. Okay, let's check things here. Great, I think we are okay. Feed things here and create a couple of iron plates. Okay, I do not have anything for that. That's also not a necessary item in here. Copper ore. Okay, so I'm missing iron. Let's gather some. That's an excess iron, and I can mine a couple of this. Oh, it's not a very fast thing. Well, in this case, there's nothing I can do about it. Feed it there. Gather the plates. And I think it's time to visit the forest, I can say, and gather some resources for biomass fuel. And in the meantime, I suppose my machines will just do their job and produce the necessary materials. I do not really want to extend my borders for a new resource and new machines just yet, because I'm not sure if I can feed them properly with this biomass resource. So I just wait for the splitter, the merger, that will make my life a little bit more easy. Oh, we have something here.
unknown crystalline mineral collected. This mineral is composed of the same chemical elements as quartz and may yield similar industrial functions. Store this potential resource for later use.
Okay, iron is also mined. That's good. I can harvest this once again. Here is some more wood. It's fine. Okay, so we are working on a basic level, and let's take all of that stuff. I think I already have some cables, that's good. Wire, it seems that I have to create the wires by hand. Couple of iron plates ready. Couple of iron rods are ready. Let's feed some iron in there. Burners filled. Very nice. This one is filled as well. Yeah, now we are working pretty good. Let's create the wires, because it seems that all of the wires are turned into cables. That's enough. Feed, okay, and I need only 30 pieces of iron plates, which I have to wait. Okay, let's put these resources into the storage. And what's the requirement for constructor? Nothing really. And I'm gonna put the constructor in here, because the screws are produced from the rods, and this is what I would like to do next. Yeah, like that. I am missing the iron plates again for the conveyor. There you go. Oh, wrong direction. Let's do it once more. So like this, okay. Now it's fine. And there. Energy. What about energy? That pole is not okay. It's also full. Okay, we are having some kind of logistics problem already. And you should create the screws. Let's take the iron rods. I should be feeding the plates. Yeah, the extractor is full. And maybe yes, I can feed it there. Oh, come on, 7 pieces are missing. Let's take this 4. 6, 7. There you go. Ooh, and we have a launch.
Milestone reached. Conveyor belts can now merge, split, and lift to save space and enhance the productivity of your factory. Fix It encourages you to consider investing in verticality when it comes to factory logistics. If you feel stressed by this complexity, imagine yourself on the shore of a vast and calm ocean. Breathe in, visualize all the people relying on you. The sea is made of billions of faces, each staring at you with hope and tears in their eyes. Breathe out, feel refreshed and focused on your duties.
Okay, that's a good advice. So let's check the hub. I have done this one. I will be able to manage things a little bit easier with these hubs. And the next thing I would like to do is the chainsaw unlock the solid biofuel, because with the help of this I am pretty able to extend my production lines, because fuel will not be a problem anymore, hopefully. So let's choose this milestone, and I think this is the end of part one. Thank you guys for watching the video, and if you just feel like, hit the like or subscribe, and we will meet each other in the next episode. Goodbye.